Hi there guys, and welcome to Guitar Interactive. My name is Tom Quayle, and today I have this rather beautiful Burns Double Six 12-string guitar to review for you. Beautiful instrument, constructed from a basswood body, a hard rock maple neck with a Goto bridge. They're Burns own trisonic pickups in a three kind of single coil style configuration. We have more modern tuning pegs than the original design would come with. So these are smaller tuning pegs, but they have a much higher ratio and are much more solid than the originals. Small logo on the top here, on the top of the headstock. Very large headstock to accommodate all 12 tuners. Looks a little bit larger than normal because the tuning pegs are smaller than they were on the previous model. We have a brass nut and a zero fret, very good for intonation and very good for general playability. A very wide neck, with a rosewood fretboard, but it's not excessively wide. The string spacing is wider than on a standard 12 string, like a Rickenbacker or something like that, for instance. This is definitely easier to play because the string spacing is wider, but if you've got small hands, you might not be able to accommodate such a wide neck, but it certainly doesn't feel uncomfortable. Really beautiful Burns shape, and you can see the manufactured by Burns of London logo. It's actually manufactured in the Far East, but this is for authentication, you know, authenticity's sake. We have a five-way selector switch to select between different combinations of pickups, volume, two tone controls, and the second tone control can be pulled up, if I can actually do that, to allow for even further pickup configurations. As a final note, the Goto bridge has been updated from the original design with individual saddles for perfect intonation, basically. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll run through the different pickup configurations on the guitar and listen to some sounds. I'm running straight into our studio amp with a clean setting with a little bit of delay on there as well, just for a little bit of ambience. Okay, so let's have a listen to the neck pickup on its own. And it sounds like this. Wow, what a great sound. I mean, 12 strings, as you know, sound superb anyway, but this is really authentic sounding. It's got that kind of sound as made famous by guys like Hank Marvin, The Shadows. Just a really great sound. So let's move to the next pickup selector setting and have a listen to the difference. Just a quick reminder, here's the original. And as we move, okay, so let's try something with this sound. We'll try some picking in this example. Again, a beautiful, clean, crisp sound. Really, really nice to play as well. I'm not feeling like I'm not struggling to make chords in this particular on this particular neck because the string spacing is wide. It really suits my hands really well, actually. Okay, let's move on. Next pickup selector setting, and we get this. Again, just wants to be strummed. It just sounds fantastic. Let's move on. Okay, next pickup selector setting. Let's try this. Thank you. Okay, and then finally, the bridge pickup. So all five of those combinations were really, really musical, with just the clean sound and a little bit of delay for ambience. Really fantastic, really nice to play. Neck's nice and flat as well, so making chords is fairly straightforward on such a wide neck, so really, really nice playability. Vintage size frets as well, which make for good playability with this particular kind of guitar. Now, if I move back to the neck position and toggle this second tone control up, we get even more configurations. We can basically use all three pickups together, the outer two together, for even more kind of tonal options. So just let me switch it back down again. Here's the neck pickup on its own. And then if I bring the tone control up, okay, and this allows us three different options. With the pickup select switch all the way to the left, we get this sound. As we move to the next one, two, three positions, we get the same sound. So you know those three settings are the same, but as we move to the right, we have another sound again. So we get another three pickups configurations, depending on whether the tone control is up, in this case, or down, giving us the normal five. So let me just run through those three again, just really quickly. So all the way to the right with the tone control up. And then in the middle position. And then all the way to the left. Okay. So intonation as well remains great all the way throughout the range of the instrument. Very in tune, superb. And let's finally just listen to the actual effect the tone control has on the pickups. So we'll roll the tone control in and out and then just check the volume control. So here's my D again. Again, all really musical. Let's try the same thing this time with the bridge pickup control, with the tone control. Again, all really musical, kind of nasally, a kind of cool sound actually. Okay, so what more is there to say? Basically, a fantastically well-constructed instrument. Very cool kind of retro looks used by modern bands like Franz Ferdinand, for instance. They're going for that kind of retro feel. Even if you're not, you're just looking for a 12-string for the studio, this is a great guitar to go for. Really musical sounding pickups and different configurations, very versatile. Very easy playability, so long as you can cope with a slightly wider neck than an average sort of 6-string or your Rickenbacker style 12-string, you'll do really well with this because the string spacing allows for great playability. Brass nut, zero fret, you know, again, enhanced playability and intonation and tone. Easy tuners to use, it's just a great guitar. So go and check one of these out. They're very good value for money with a hard case. They even come with a strap. Everything is just high quality. It screams really well made at you. So hope you've enjoyed this review and I will see you next time.